Standard precautions need to be followed regardless of suspected or confirmed infectious status of the patient in any setting where healthcare is delivered. These practices are designed to both protect the healthcare provider and prevent the healthcare provider from spreading infections among patients. Standard precautions include hand hygiene, use of personal protective equipment, examples of that would be gloves or gowns or masks, safe injection practices, safe handling of potentially contaminated equipment or surfaces in the patient environment, and respiratory hygiene and cough etiquette. Some general principles for healthcare professionals include the following. To avoid the spread of bloodborne pathogens and infectious diseases, healthcare professionals have an ethical and professional responsibility to adhere to scientifically accepted or evidence-based practices and principles of infection control, and to monitor the performance of those for whom the professional is responsible. Multiple organizations publish best practices for infection control, but some states include a legal responsibility to adhere to infection control practices. Follow the guidelines for your facility. Hospital-associated infection, or an HAI, also known as a nosocomial infection, are those that originate or occur in a hospital or hospital-like setting. The CDC estimates, in American hospitals alone, that healthcare-associated infections account for 1.7 million infections, and 99,000 of those are associated with deaths each year. Infections can be associated with the devices used in medical procedures such as catheters or ventilators. The most common types of hospital-associated infections are bloodstream infection, pneumonia, ventilator-associated pneumonia, urinary tract infection, and surgical site infection. A urinary tract infection is the most common type of healthcare-associated infection. It's often associated with the placement of a catheter or tube that's used to empty urine from the bladder. Having surgery can increase a patient's risk of getting an infection by giving bacteria a pathway into a normally sterile area of the body. Following surgery, the surgical wound can become infected when the dressing is changed. Ventilator-associated pneumonias occur when bacteria and other germs get into the lungs from an endotracheal tube that is attached to a ventilator. When the bacteria begin to grow in the tube, an infection develops that leads to pneumonia. Bacteria can enter the body at the site of where an IV or catheter is inserted. A local infection may develop in the skin around the catheter. The bacteria can also enter the blood through the veins that go near the heart and cause a more serious infection called sepsis. The deeper and longer a catheter is in place, the greater the chance of developing an infection. Common pathogens that cause the hospital-associated infections are Staphylococcus aureus, Pseudomonas aeruginosa, E. coli, Klebsiella, and Clostridium difficile. MRSA, methicillin-resistant Staphylococcus aureus, is a strain of staph that's resistant to the broad-spectrum antibiotics commonly used to treat it. MRSA, or MRSA, can be fatal. Pseudomonas aeruginosa, pathogens that are highly resistant to antibiotics. Because antibiotics are usually non-effective, it can lead to a more serious infection, like septicemia, a urinary tract infection, pneumonia, or chronic lung infections. Now, for E. coli, typically it's caused is severe stomach cramps, diarrhea, which are often bloody, and vomiting. Some E. coli strains can be life-threatening. Klebsiella is a type of gram-negative bacteria that can cause different types of healthcare-associated infections, including pneumonia or bloodstream infections, wound or surgical site infections, and meningitis. Clostridium difficile, known as C. diff, can cause gastrointestinal infection. C. diff spores are transferred to patients mainly via the hands and healthcare personnel who have touched a contaminated surface or item. Patients most at risk are the elderly, especially those already on antibiotics. C. diff is often a result of overuse or improper use of antibiotics. When it comes to infectious diseases, prevention is the primary strategy for reducing the incidence of hospital-acquired infections. Patients aren't coming to be treated to get more sick. They're coming to get well. And it's yours and my responsibility to do what we're supposed to do to make sure that they are getting the best and the most healthy treatment possible.